Hello and welcome to Droidbox. In today's video, we'll be unboxing and demonstrating the brand new Droidbox Go V3 mini projector. So, on with the unboxing. Inside, you have the Droidbox Go V3, which we'll show more detail in a moment. English user manual to get you started. HDMI cable for the HDMI input, a tripod which goes onto the projector, we'll show that in a moment, a remote control. Unlike the previous model, this isn't infrared, it uses a USB dongle, so you can use that anywhere in the room without having to directly point at the projector. It's a power adapter. So in this we'll include the right adapter for your country when sending it. Carry bag for the projector. Onto the device. So this is the new model with a touch interface. So instead of buttons you just simply push them. So you've got the navigation buttons, menu and back buttons. On the bottom you've got a headphone socket. On the side, you've got the HDMI input, power supply, two USB ports, the on-off switch. On the back, you've got where the lens is. And on this side, you've got the focus button for the lens and a SD card slot. On the bottom, you've got a flap here, which you can lift up to tilt the projector slightly. And here is the screw hole for the tripod. So that just quickly fits inside and you can use that to stand up your projector. So what we'll do next is show you a brief demonstration of the Droidbox Go V3 up and running.
Please note there is some flickering and changes in the colour. This is due to the video camera recording not synchronising and is not the actual output of the projector.
The Go V3 launcher uses our own Droidbox launcher for quick access to commonly used apps such as DBMC, YouTube, Google Play Store and Droidbox Market. You can also use the original launcher if you prefer. There are a range of apps installed on the Go V3 including our own build of Kodi called DBMC. There's also Droidbox Control Center and Droidbox Market. It comes with the latest version of Kodi, which at the time of this video is version 17.3. Other apps include the OTA firmware updater, Netflix and FTMC.
In this demo we are showing clips from trailers of forthcoming films. As you can see, the quality is very clear and bright. You can also use the HDMI input to connect your PC or laptop, set-top box, Blu-ray player or even another Droidbox up to it. What we particularly like is that the remote control is not infrared but is now wireless, so you do not have to point directly at the projector to use the remote. The Go V3 keystone correction improves over the V2 with both automatic and manual keystone correction. If your V3 is going to be fixed to a ceiling mount, for example, you can manually adjust the keystone and you should not need to change it again. If you use it in a variety of different places and at different heights, then the automatic keystone works great for ease and speed. The Go V3 improvements over the V2, such as keystone features, wireless remote, Android 5, 2GB of RAM and 16GB of storage, make this a great solution for everything from a portable cinema experience to work presentations. You can find out more information on the Go V3 by clicking the link in the description.